Oh, hello smart investors. Money can't buy me love. We know this Beatles song. Investments can't make you rich. Wait, what? Are you serious? I come here to know only good about investments. But we have met incredibly profitable years in the history of the stock market since 2009. Long bull market, and for the last 5 years even the S&P 500 index has brought in almost insane 15% of real profitability already, after deducting inflation. Good times lull the vigilance, and now it seems to us that it will always be so. Also, the average historical return of the index was in the area of 6.5%. And it may seem to a fresh investor that he will soon be able to make a fortune in this way. Really? What reasons lead us to believe that this will continue to be so? And none. This is the market zone, anything can happen here, but with an average historical return which, for good reason, it is better to count on in your plan at 6.5%, you will have to wait for a doubling of capital for about 11 years. Although some risk-reward charts at the end of May 2021 in general already showed negative returns on the S&P 500 index in future. And is it generally correct to look at the future profitability of the American market? After all, if the American market was better in the past, it doesn't mean at all that it will become a leader in the future. In 1901, do you think the American market would be the best on the horizon for 120 years? Or maybe you would have invested in the then best markets, can I say like this? Probably like Germany, Europe or Europe. What if the next 120 years pass under the growth of China? I certainly don't think so, and I don't think that it's necessary to change the horse. But still, it will be more correct to look at the profitability of the entire world market, and not just the United States. So then, our annual profitability, alas, is generally reduced to 5% annually. Yes, in the last century there were two world wars and a lot of different cataclysms, problems and crises. But at the same time, the growth of science and technology discoveries was at an unprecedented level, which perhaps will not happen again. Why do I say that? AMD officially began shipping the Athlon 64X2 dual-core processor at Computex on June 1st, 2005, as far as I remember. Then it was a landmark breakthrough, and it might seem that then the number of cores would start multiplying again to thousands. But no, where are they? I'm still on a 2-core laptop, and you are probably okay on a 4-core one. Well, you get the idea. Sucks in short. A lot of years have passed, and as everything slowed down, it also slows down now. God forbid you to open 30-40 tabs in your browser these days. We're not on Mars yet, so whether the development of science and technology will continue to contribute to the rapid and large increase in the efficiency and profits of corporations, we don't know. Probably. And 5% of the annual return doubles our capital not in 5 years, but only in 14 years. The tubers show portfolios with hundreds of thousands of dollars and sometimes millions of dollars, and we may get the false impression that this capital was made there. But you can't make big capital quickly. As a rule, look at which of them and where made their money, and only then invested it in the stock market. One earned money as a real estate agent, another sold his startup, the third saved up his whole life and at a cool job and retired. And the eighth worked in Google, and 13 made money in business. The 40th has been saving up for 22 years in investing, might be losing to an index every year, and even he now has a big capital. And now all of them, we go to YouTube and tell newcomers about how to invest properly. Do they know? I don't know, but I know for sure. On the one hand, this can demotivate you in investing. although it should not. On the other hand, the faster you understand the reality, the faster you will make the right decisions in investing and your precious, unique life. I know this from myself. I had a period when I was very eager with investments and listened to inspiring characters, read the stories of all sorts of billionaires, and sometimes did not want to notice the forest for the trees. I began to think in the wrong direction. I calmed down, and it seemed to me that now I just need to wait, and capital multiplying several times can make me wealthy. Well, maybe, but I may not live, most likely to the desired point, even if I do not make mistakes that stop compound interest. You can wait a long time, but in the end, it turns out that your expectations for profitability or account replenishment were overestimated, and you should not relax and indulge in complacency, not counting the annual return of 15% in your financial plan, and so on. Investing is like building a house. Replace a couple of components in the foundation, save on insulation, the walls, on high quality painting, and after a few years you'll understand why experienced builders do not recommend you doing this. I know what I'm talking about because I have never built a house. It's almost impossible to redo the foundation of a newly built house. Fortunately, having realized the wrong decisions in investments, you will probably have time to change your plan and strategy to the correct one. Bringing the allocation to the recommended one, for example. But the time has already passed. Money is not earned on the stock market for most of us. Its purchasing power is preserved on the stock market. It is not the stock market that will make you rich, but its regular replenishment, top-ups and disciplined asset purchases. Thus, the most important conclusion. Being able to accumulate and to save is a more important skill than even investing itself. If you regularly invest a lot of money, even in bonds, you will soon have a large portfolio. But if you invest little money, even at high returns, you are likely to become rich. Also, the main problem is the discrepancy between theory and practice. In theory, the market return is one, but in practice, the average investor always gets less, and a couple of percent less every year. That over long distance can at all erase the meaning of investing, since the overtaking of inflation will be scanty. So please like and subscribe to this video to know how not to be an average investor who wanted to be better than the market and was fussing and crying as a result. It's difficult from a psychological point of view. First of all, you need to save money steadily and for decades. But during this time, your plans change many times. But math is not interested in your problems. Sorry, she needs regular top-ups to her brokerage account, whether you get sick or not. And also, you will need to have yourself all these years and not go astray. That is why I'm creating these videos, so that all of us as investors feel supported and do not forget about the right course. You can read Dalbert's report on the behavior of the average investor yourself, but you probably don't want to. So that's why I'm here. To start and give you a squeeze, investors so often cost themselves money because the behaviors elicited by short-term focus are almost always irrational. In years of uncertainty, investors get nervous and this affects the quality of decisions. In 2016, they simply underperformed S&P 500 index by 5%. This 5% has a huge impact on long-term results, interrupting the rate of accumulation of compound interest. Don't do it! Investors are impatient and move into and out of the investment too frequently. Typically 36 to 56 months depending on the type of a fund. We have also seen that inflows and outflows all too frequently come at the worst possible time. Don't do market timing. never quit the market. By the way, this is John Bogle's phrase. Investors tend to sell risky assets after a big fall or in times of crisis, exactly when their expected profitability increases. That is, they sell when you need to buy them. The assets, of course, psychology is to blame. Let's talk about this in the next videos. I don't want to stretch one video for a long time and get involved in several subjects at once. Hope you understand the topic and it's clear now. Let's invest properly and work on a cash flow from our jobs, businesses and activities. There is the best point of force application. I really appreciate your attention. Do not be discouraged in investments, friends, for many years we will be lucky too. Thank you and see you in the next videos. Please like this video and subscribe.